Hi everyone, I miss you all. I hope that you are staying safe and well. We are at the beautiful City of Motion Dance Theater, where there's lots of space to move around so we can videotape these sequences for you. And this is my daughter, Marina Vianello, who arrived recently from New York. I'm trying to stay at a safe social distancing. Really hard to do. And she's gonna help demonstrate. And then my son, Gabriel Vianello, is doing the videotaping and the music. Thanks, Gabriel.
Yeah.
So today we're gonna do the Warrior Three sequence. And I always recommend stretching out your hamstring before doing this, your hamstrings. So Marina's just gonna show a flat back. You can use a tabletop, a counter in your kitchen. You don't have to have a bar, obviously. So she's gonna stretch into her flat back and her hips pull back. If you can have your feet wide or together, and you just want that long stretch this way. If you need to bend your knees, go ahead and just bend to demonstrate. We're gonna bend your knees a little bit. Kind of wiggle your hips sideways just to get some release in your lower back. Loosen up your hamstrings a little bit. And then she's gonna come up flat back. Good. And she's gonna take her right foot forward for a calf stretch, like a warrior one, just to open up the calf muscles, get some stretch along the back of her leg, keeping her chest open, just breathing here. And then a nice one to do next is a modified pyramid. So she's gonna keep her front knee bent and then just pull your hips back. And yeah, so she's gonna stretching out the back, but also getting a little more stretch in the hamstring on the front of the leg. Do you feel like a little bit of stretch there? Okay, good. Then, if you can, so she gets a little more advanced, she's gonna straighten her front knee, pull her hips back gently, and flex her front foot. So getting a little more deeper into the hamstring. Good. And then the final one is just folding over her leg into a full pyramid. If this is too much on your hamstrings, just do the first couple once. And then she can roll up if she wants or come flat back. And let's just quickly do the other side. So start with the wide back again. Wide legs, flat back. Maybe bring your chest up just a little so you're more of a tabletop. Yeah, that's good. And then roll up, flat back up. Good. Left leg forward. Calf stretch. So you want a nice long line from the back of the head down through that back heel. Make sure you can go slower than this. Just take several deep breaths in each position. Then her front knee stays bent, and she's going to go into this modified pigeon. So do you feel a little more stretch in the hamstring?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Keeping the hips square if you can. So kind of pull back. Yeah, with that working hip. And now she's going to straighten her front leg and flex her front foot. So try not to hyperextend. Maybe a little softness behind the knee so you don't just overextend that knee. Good. And then the final one is going all the way over to a full pyramid if you want. Continuing to keep this hip square if you can. Yep. Good. And rolling up. Flat back. Good. And you can even push forward a little if you want to kind of open up through the hip flexors. Does that look good? Start with a cleansing breath in, deep breath in. Exhale all the air out. Thumb and first finger together. Take a deep breath in. Zip up the core. Exhale, scoop it out. We
forward fold to Paschimottanasana. Paschimottanasana. Pano means feet. So here, you need to bend your knees low. Please do. You want to keep the mat elongated, not round. So she's going to take her left hand under her shoulder, and she's going to spiral open with the right. Come up, hands on your hips. You're going to come up with a flat back, bringing the pelvis right underneath your shoulders into warrior two. She lifts her right heel. Good. Her left toes can turn in a little. Keep your hips facing the front wall. Reach out for your arms. Bend your front knee. Making sure that knee's right over your ankle and your weight's evenly distributed on your toes. Shoulders down. Breath in, and she's going to lift her back heel and come into warrior one. Making sure the legs right behind your hip. Yeah. So you can adjust it a little bit if you need to. So you want everything square through the pelvis. And then she's going to take her arms up to the Hastasana position with the palms together. And if that's not comfortable on your shoulders, you can open up the hands and reach up. Here, warrior three or airplane pose. So she's going to slowly shift her weight over her front foot, reaching with her arms. So you find your foundation, find a focal point, a few feet forward. This leg just stays straight behind your hip. And arms like a T, like a bunch of cords. Beautiful. To put on a little bend your front knee, just tap your back toe and come back to your warrior one. Zip up the front side of your body. Good. Keep pushing down with your feet. Breathe in. Look up. And exhale. Slow forward fold. Take your time. Soften at the bottom. So here, Maria, let's just do a few weight shifts. So if you need to kind of release your lower back, or just, yeah, go ahead and do that. This is for your body. Always modify as needed. Then, finding your, this is Prasthavita Padottanasana. Actually, you can take the hands right to the toes if you want. It's kind of fun. But for the spiral, we walk the hands forward. So the right hand goes under the chest, and then you open up. Good. Deep breath in. Exhale, find the center. To help neutralize the spine, and this is really a nice heart opener for the chest. Try to keep the neck relaxed, breathe in, and then take the hands down. Deep breath in, exhale, push down into the